Hello everyone. Now we are going to study Doberaner's triads. The German chemist Johann Wolfgang Doberaner in the year 1817, he started studying the elements and tried to classify the elements. He arranged the elements with the similar properties in groups. His groups contain only three elements each and hence they were called as triads. According to his law, in the Doberaner's triads, when the elements are arranged in the increasing order of their atomic masses, the atomic mass of the middle element was roughly the average of the atomic mass of the other two elements. In Doberaner's triads, let us understand this with the help of the example. We are taking the first example, that is lithium, sodium and potassium. These are the three elements arranged in the increasing order of their atomic masses. Let us see the atomic mass of lithium, that is 6.9. Round up, you can take 7. Of sodium, it is 23.0. And potassium, that is 39.0. According to his law, if we take the mean of the two elements, that is first and the last element, first and the third element, you will find that you will get the atomic mass of the middle element. Let us try. 6.9 plus 39 divided by 2, you get 45.9 upon 2, and then finally 22.9, and average approximately it is 23. Hence, according to his law, you find that the atomic mass of the middle element, that is of sodium, that is 23. Atomic mass of the middle element is the arithmetic mean of the other two. Other two, that is first and the last, or first and the third. So atomic mass of sodium is the arithmetic mean of lithium and potassium in this case. Let us see another example, that is calcium, strontium and barium. Here the atomic masses are given. If you calculate, you will find that strontium having 87.6, it is the mean of calcium and barium's atomic mass. And the next example, that is chlorine, bromine and iodine. These are the atomic masses, and if you again calculate, you will find the same thing, that is the atomic mass of the middle element is the approximate mean of the other two. During the Doberaner's time, only few elements were known. He studied all those elements. He made the triads. Triads contain three elements each. Whatever was his law, that is the atomic mass of the middle element was the arithmetic or approximate mean of the atomic masses of the other two elements. It was followed only by these three triads. Though Doberaner has tried the classification, he has done some study, he has given the triad, he has given the law, and his law was followed by some of the elements, that is three triads were formed. But for the further elements, elements having higher atomic mass, they did not follow Doberaner's triads. Hence, the study of Doberaner was not successful. He got failed, but still he has done some work. And because of this, his information led to the development of the periodic table of the elements. Hence, in short, we have completed the Doberaner's triad.